The salvation and redemption of Israel, the Lord's people. I want to give all honor, glory, and praises to Yahweh, Ba'ashim Yahushai, Ba'ashim Ra'ucha Kodash. Double honor to my elders at Great Millstone. Talk from this truth through the Spirit. Sing an honest to the elect. Peace and blessing to the one third. And to the confusion of faces in the four corners of the earth. Shalom. Let's get right into it. Going right into Luke, the first chapter. This is going to go into the redemption and the salvation of the nation of Israel, the Lord's people. All right. Much evidence out there, so-called Negro Latinos and Native Americans make up the children of Israel, not just the 10 lost tribes, all the tribes. And this is future prophecy of us being in our enemy's hand, in our enemy's land. We're still in our enemy's hand, y'all. We're still in the land of our enemy. We're just not in shackles, you know. They're just not hitting us with a bullwhip. Now they have mental chains on us, and they use the pen as the whip through legislations and the laws of the land. All right, the laws of man rather than the laws of the Most High. But anyways, all these heavy curses are still upon us. So curses on us mean that we need to be redeemed from our sins. Remember, sin is the transgression of the law. Pretty much sin would be like running a red light. Sin would be like robbing a bank. You understand what I'm saying? Assaulting someone. It would be like breaking a crime in today's society. We did that as a nation of people. So when you hear about redemption and salvation in the Bible, it goes back to a covenant. A covenant the Lord made with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Had nothing to do with the heathen nations who are outside of the nation of Israel. A heathen is anyone that is not from the lineage, the stock of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. That's it, okay? A Gentile is anyone who's not of the stock of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and or Hebrew Israelites who took on the foreign customs, the culture of these other nations. Hence, Greek-speaking Israelites who took on Greek customs as well will be known as Hellenists in secular history. Why am I telling you all of this? Who's lost or who needs to be found? Who's broken and needs to be healed? Who needs a physician? It'll be us. Outside of the rest of the world, no one else had to go through what we went through from 1492 all the way up until now. And we're still reaping. Now, I'm not saying reaping. They're reaping the benefits of slavery. We're still suffering from the effects. It's called post-slavery. An amalgamation of black is just post-slavery. It has nothing to do with who we are as Judahites. You know, the post-amalgamation of Puerto Rican has nothing to do with us being Ephraimites. I can go on and on and on. So let's get to it. This is Luke chapter 1, verse 67. And his father, Zacharias, was filled with the Holy Spirit and prophesied, saying, hold on. Let's get this clear really quick. Who's Zacharias? Father of John the Baptist. So understand who's talking. The father of John the Baptist. John the Baptist, who was also the major prophet Elijah, for those who can understand it. Read Matthew the 11th chapter. And his father Zacharias was filled with the Holy Spirit and prophesied, saying, blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he hath visited and redeemed his people. He hath raised up an horn of salvation for us in the house of his servant David. It says, blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he hath visited and redeemed his people. Let's go into that word redeem to get a better understanding.
Strong's G 3085.
Lutrosis. A ransoming, redemption, deliverance, especially from the penalty of sin. Indeed. From the penalty of sin. So, that would mean to be redeemed from the penalty of sin, that would mean that Yahushua blood would redeem them. Hold on. From the penalty of sin, bear with me for a moment, y'all. Bear with me for a little moment. This is Acts chapter 5, verse 27. Remember, the word redeem means a ransom, or especially from the penalty of sin. It's like being pardoned by the warden in the penitentiary. Acts 5 and 27. And when they have brought them, they set them before the council. And the high priest asked them, saying, did not we straitly command you that ye should not teach in this name? And behold, ye have filled Jerusalem with your doctrine, and intend to bring this man's blood upon us. You notice how they say they told him that he should not teach in that name. See how important the name is? This was over 2,000 years ago. Let's just say around 2,000 years ago. So when the elders go so hard against other groups, especially IUYC and ISUPK, who professed the name prior, now they're not professing the name anymore. Man, they took the bag. And nonetheless, the scripture says, there is no other name under heaven wherein men might be saved. Notice, saved. Again, so many variables to salvation, people. But the first one is, you have to be an Israelite to begin with. So let's go. Verse 29, then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, we ought to obey God rather than men. To hell with what y'all say, how y'all feel. Well, how about Shemiyah Israel? Well, they say Israel. The God of our fathers. Notice it keeps saying the God of our fathers, the God of Israel, the God of our fathers. And this is New Testament, people, so y'all can cut all that out. The God of our fathers, not all, our fathers raised up Yahushua, whom ye slew and hanged on a tree. Letter J didn't exist 2,000 years ago because English didn't exist 2,000 years ago. Get out your feelings and get in your head, people. Here comes the point. Verse 31, him have the God, Yahweh, exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior, for to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sins. So repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sins. Really quick. I wasn't planning on going to the word repentance, but since we're here,
Strong's G 3341. Metanoia.
It says a change of mind as it appears to one who repents of a purpose he has formed or of something he has done. And that reminds me of 2 Peter, the third verse, where it says, I stir up your pure minds by way of remembrance. Now, we went into redemption, redeem, and we went into repentance. Now, let's continue. Luke 1 and 68, blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he hath visited and redeemed his people. How does the Lord visit us? For one, he done it also with the Spirit, the Rabbi HaKodesh. And have raised up an horn of salvation for us in the house of his servant David. So going to the word salvation, you have to get context, you know? You have to go in depth, go into words and get better understanding. That's what our elders taught us. Elders are a great millstone. So, deliverance, preservation. Oops.
Strong's G, 4991. Soteria.
All right, soteria. Deliverance, preservation, safety, salvation. All right, deliverance from the molestation of enemies. The ethical sense, that which concludes to the soul's safety or salvation. Or messianic salvation. I'm just reading this. Salvation as the present possession of all true Christians. No. The disciples was first called Christians at Antioch in the book of Acts, the 11th chapter. Nothing to do with what y'all claim to be Christian. Stop it. Future salvation is some of benefits and blessings with the Christians who are Israelites. Israelites. But this is the point I want to get at too. It says scripture describes a fourfold salvation. Saved from the penalty, power, presence, and pleasure of sin. Once again, what is sin? A transgression of the law. Who was the law given to? The nation of Israel. When Moses went up on Mount Sinai for 40 days and 40 nights, who was at the bottom of the mountain? The nation of Israel with a golden freaking calf. The law was only given to Israel, none other. So there's no way you can have repentance. Even the Lord said it for Esau, for one morsel of meat, who sold his birthright. He said, though he sought it carefully with tears, there was no place of repentance. So even the whole nation of Israel, not Israel, Salake, Esau, Edomites, y'all don't have no way. Y'all have no, not even a slim chance, let alone any of the heathens. All right. Let's get back to it. So, as he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets, which have been since the world began. Now, breaking bread with the brother Lawat, and this is heavy. He spake by the mouth of his holy prophets. So as we speak, it's the Lord speak. It's Matthew 10 and 20, where Yahweh shall say, it is not you the speaker, but it's the spirit of the Father that speaketh within you. Ooh. You see what I'm saying? But that we should be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all that hate us. Come on, look at us as a people. We are the undesirables. We are the tail. They don't listen here, people. Talk about you so-called Negro Latinos and Native Americans. Esau will never accept you. He only tolerates you. They're ruling. Why would he need you? Other than for financial gains, right? More than likely. Like they say, if they give him LeBron James like a 2-year, $120 million contract, how much you think they're really making off of him with them 2 years? That's the point. Anyhow, as much as a king they claim him to be, that we should be saved from our enemies. And I'm also a LeBron fan, so I'm being 100 about this, especially when he had that old small hat and curly hair, had that old Israeli holding his hand and guiding him like he a little boy. Bro, you like 6'9", like 260. This dude like 5'6", freaking 175 pounds probably. He guiding your hand like you a little child. But anyways, let's get back to it. To perform the mercy promised to our fathers. Listen, to our fathers, not all, to our fathers, and to remember his holy covenant. You noticing that, right? To remember his holy covenant, the covenant, which is like a contract which was never broken. Matter of fact, let's just go there since we're here. I'm trying not to make this too long. You know how it is when the spirit turn on. And I'm kind of doing some of these words kind of raw, like this one here.
Strong's G 1242. Diatheke. Diatheke.
Ooh, this is cold. Whew. A disposition arrangement. We will, of any sort which one wishes to be valid, the last disposition which one makes of his earthly possessions after his death, a testament or will, a compact, a covenant, a testament, God's covenant with Noah. You know what's beautiful about the word covenant? It's pretty much a contract. Like it says, a strong definition, what it says. Properly a disposition, i.e. especially a contract, a divisory will. So this is the Lord said, I'm willing to make you a great nation among all nations on the earth if you keep my commandments. If you don't, this would be the penalty. That's the covenant. For prime example, what was the Most High's covenant with Noah after he saved his family? The Lord made a covenant by making a rainbow in the sky too. He said, this will be a covenant that he would never flood the earth again. So if it's very, 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 very heavy rain one day, y'all, and you just so happen to look up in the sky and see a rainbow, that's this insignia of the Lord too, a covenant, a pact he made with all people on earth, really, to not flood the earth. That's what it means. Yeah, you get flash floods, you get tidal waves, tsunamis, but to flood the entire earth is different. All right, so it's like a contract, it's a promise. Like the Lord made a promise to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He never broke that covenant. Never broke that pact and said, let's revise. It's like an NBA, oh, let's rip up this contract and make another one. No, it wasn't nothing like that. It's still the same thing. All right? Now, let's close out. Trying to. Luke 1 and 73, the oath which he swore to our father Abraham. Here we go. That he would grant unto us that we being delivered. Listen here. That we being delivered out of the hand of our enemies might serve him without fear. That's future, y'all, when we get into the land. In the holiness and righteousness before him all the days of our life. So remember, the repentance, the redemption, the salvation. And there's another word right here. The redemption. It's the redemption, the repentance, and the salvation, and the covenant is only for Israel. That's pretty much the title right there. But with that being said, pray you was edifying, fair, stay in the spirit of fear, just endure it. Ask for forgiveness, pray without ceasing, stay humble, remain diligent. Kwame Allah, wafla babal, shalom.